Yo guys, and welcome back to another video. This is going to be very different from my normal videos, as we know gameplay. I'm going to instead talk to you about the Dead by Daylight MMR system and how this applies to broader MMR systems in other games, and how the recent changes of increasing the soft cap may impact or may not impact your games. So let's start off. This is the Dead by Daylight wiki. These are the skill brackets. From what I understand, these are taken from like actual data mined sets of information that people have found from the game files. So this is factual information as to what is happening when the game is trying to assess your skill. So the points of interest are 650, which is where newcomers go, where they are put into a testing skill bracket to see how good they are. They then move up if they win to 900 to 1,000 points, which is considered the bottom skill bracket. You then get up to 1,600 and above, which is the top skill bracket. It says here this bracket is the widest. It encompasses all players that MMR scores up to the maximum of 3,000 points. And then you have over 2,000 is where professional players go, such as streamers and content creators. And then 2,400 and above is for the most proficient Dead by Daylight players. Interestingly, there doesn't seem to be anything between 2,500 and 3,000. Maybe that only concerns like less than 50 players, you know, very, very top level pros. But I think it's safe to assume that people like Ottsdava and Hens, players like this, very high level streamers, are 2,000 MMR and above. And down here we have caps. We have the new change of the 2,100 point soft cap, and then the hard cap at 3,000 points. So you cannot go above 3,000, and at 2,100, you get significantly reduced gains towards MMR. So you can still increase in MMR, however, it's very, very difficult. So, what does this mean? Well, Dead by Daylight, as with any other game, as with many, many other things in life, can be modeled using the normal distribution. I'm going to read this verbatim for a second, but in stats, a normal distribution or Gaussian distribution is a type of continuous probability distribution for a real valued random variable. The general form of its probability density function is this, f of x equals something, something, something. This isn't important to understand what the function does. What's important is that these two parameters, you have mu and sigma. Mu is the mean or the average, and then sigma is one standard deviation. What do these things mean? If we look at the probability theory graph below, we see that mu, the average, goes in the middle. That's what average means. And then a standard deviation moves from one part to the left, which is a mu minus sigma, and then one part to the right, which is mu plus sigma. So within one standard deviation of the mean, you have roughly 70% of the population of any given normal distribution. So think 70% of players in Dead by Daylight are within one standard deviation of being average. And then you have 15% are below that and 15% are above that. So I've tried to model this in a way that will be somewhat useful to you guys. This is my version of the normal distribution curve modeled with Dead by Daylight figures. So we have 3,000 at the top, 0 at the bottom. We have 1,000, which is what they call the bottom skill bracket, and then 600 would be somewhere in this little pit, which is the testing skill bracket. And if you're really, really bad at the game, you won't be able to get to 1,000, and you will only play against babies. They do say it's a testing skill bracket, and you play against other players that are being tested. So once you get up to 1,000, you enter the general matchmaking pool, which is between this blue line and this blue, or potentially this green line, which I will explain in a second. So we have the mean here, which should be about average. This could change, but should be about average. And then we have what I would assume to be one standard deviation, roughly splitting the bottom skill bracket and the mean in half. And you'd have a further, like, probably not even important to write these, but you'd have further little blue lines. But as we know from that graph, if I go back into gold here, take off snap. This is like less than 1% of the player base would fit into this. Ignore that. But 1%, 1%. And then, as I said, 15% is below one standard deviation, and 15% is above one standard deviation. So you can see here, just above 2,000 points, I've put Ots, and then above a further standard deviation, you know, closer to 3,000 MMR, you're talking professional. You know, think Eternal or whatever. Think of the best pro team that you know. That's where those guys are. And for most of us, we'll be in this 70% bracket. That is you and me, believe it or not. And then 1600 is where they said that the top skill bracket exists. 1600. This seems quite low to me to be at a top skill bracket. And this probably close to cuts in half the average and the first standard deviation. It's probably somewhere around 1750, I would say, this blue line. So that sort of signals that like close to 50% of people in the game are in the top skill bracket. It's at least 15%, but yeah, it could be like 40%, maybe a third of players. That's quite high to me. That seems very, very high. And then you have this new soft cap 2100, which is all the way up here. And as they said from the data mining information, 2000 and above is people like Ots Dava. You know, it's that seems quite high to have a soft cap. It makes me wonder what the point of that even is. So to explain to you guys why games feel a bit different when the MMR skill cap changes, what's happening is by introducing this green line at 2100, it basically flattens this entire side of the graph. Anywhere from the best player in the world, 3000 MMR, there probably is no one at 3000 MMR to be honest, but everyone from there down to 2100 is considered the same skill. And the implications of that are if you are reasonably high MMR, but not Ots Dava level MMR. So let's say somewhere, what can I use here? Orange. Let's say you're pretty good, right? Let's say you're like here. You're like 1800. And let's call that me. I'm not saying I am, but I'm going to use me as an example. Let's say I pick a killer. I get pretty good at them. I win loads of games. I go on like a 30-game win streak or something like that. Then I could quite feasibly reach this and enter the top 15, the top 10% of players in the game. With a significant amount of hours, you will find yourself in this bracket. What that means is that very quickly, you put yourself within the matchmaking ladder of the soft cap. So you will now match equally against people of a very, very, very high MMR as you will people of around this level, 2100 and a bit below. And then, of course, you can also play against people sort of, you know, this area. So we're talking about this little banding here. So what that means, by increasing the soft cap, people close to the soft cap or above it will have a higher frequency of games with people of a higher skill level in them. So players like Ots Dava, for example, he's done lots of challenges in the game where he does like long streaks with like random perks or certain like restrictions on him, like 30 seconds AFK, no perks, no add-ons, all these kinds of things. Now, what this means is with games becoming consistently more difficult with a higher skill cap introduced, challenges like this will be more difficult because you will more regularly play against people of your actual skill rather than playing against people of a more generalized skill, which is what happens when you have a lower skill cap. So I think for the average player in Dead by Daylight, you probably won't see a tremendous amount of increase in difficulty in your games. And in fact, in some cases, they might actually get easier because all the soft cap players like Ots Dava are playing each other instead of being in your games. So if you're in this 70% bracket, you're probably pretty chilling. But if you go into this bracket, the top 15% bracket, which is what I used myself as an example, if you become really good at a killer, then you will actually start playing really high level people, and all of your games, or say all of them, a very high frequency of your games will feature very, very, very sweaty players indeed, with the best builds, the best perks. They're probably on comms, they've got good strategy, a good game understanding, and you're probably going to start hating your life. And if you do find yourself up at this 1800 bracket, then who knows, you might have such difficult games that you start to fall back down towards the average, towards the main 70% pool, and your games will start getting easier. I, for one, have felt, you know, this is purely anecdotally, of course, but I felt that my games are getting more difficult. I've certainly lost a lot more games in terms of a frequency of the games I'm losing, much higher frequency than I did in the past several weeks. So who knows? Yeah, I may have been at this banding. You never know. 1800, and I'm probably not anymore because I've lost quite a few. So yeah, try and take this information, try and use it to aid your understanding. Note that a lot of this is conjecture. It's just me using information I've given and trying to sort of come up with explanations as to how this might fit into the wider MMR situation. But there are very few facts here other than these MMR values that have been data mined. With that, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope it helped you in some way. Perhaps it will help your understanding of other MMR systems in other games. But if you liked it, then please like, please subscribe. If you like this sort of thing, I can do more of mathematical breakdowns of video games. I don't know. But yeah, cool. I hope you like it, and I'll see you in the next one.